bitches is cooler. Wait, these are they mine, and it's only these some hundred times that I keep them bucks. They be on my mind. Tuck these, I bucks these on your mind. Pause, to feed them on my grind. Get a beat a little up, keep them.
And welcome to this exhibition clash between the Dallas Cowboys and the Washington Redskins.
And Chris, as we take a look at this matchup, you can't help but mention the word rivalry.
Well, when you talk about rivalries, a lot of people would probably put this matchup near the top of their list. The Cowboys and Redskins, they share a lot of history between them, and that's intensified the games over the years.
All right, Chris, with that in mind, it's game time, and we've got two teams really ready to rumble. Gano has the ball all teed up, and he looks ready to get this game underway. Ingram was there for the stop.
Number 28 on the return.
They'll start at the 18-yard line. It's first and 10. Pitch right. O.J. Otagwe was there to bring him down. Gets maybe a couple.
Gain of two on the play.
Second down and 9. Murray, again, hammered in the backfield.
Did you see how fast that linebacker was on that one? Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
They need 9 on this third down if they want to convert. Ball on the 19. Looking for a man. D'Angelo Hall was there for the stop. What happened there?
Well, the defense was in zone coverage. They got good pass protection, and anytime that happens, it tends to really stretch those zones and widen the holes.
Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 42. Has a man to his right. The pass is tipped. Austin was the intended receiver on the play. They'll face second down and 10. Ball on their own 42. Don't get scared, baby. Don't get Murray gets the carry. He's tackled around the 47-yard line by Cofield. Third down now, 5 yards to go. Steps and throws to the left side. He's brought down right around the 38-yard line by Wilson. First down and 10.
Ball on the 38. Romo hands it off straight ahead. Riley will make his way to the bench. Seems like he got banged up on that last play. Could be a shoulder. So they'll face a second and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Ryan Arakpo was there to bring him down.
The ball carrier, gain of one.
It's third down, 9 yards to go. On their own 37.
Get ready.
Fires a strike to the right. Right through his hands. He almost had the pick. The defender gets a hand on it, and that will bring up fourth down.
And those are the kind of big third down plays you have to have on defense to get the ball back and give your team a chance on offense.
Number 29 on the run. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Brady James was there for the stop. He's searching for a receiver. Terrence Newman was there to bring him down.
Patience for a wide receiver is just so key. He's able to manipulate that defense, set him up one play, come back with the exact same look, and break off of it the next. Beautifully run.
Garrard hands it left. It's picked up. A burst of speed, and he's in the open.
Well, there's really never a good time for a fumble, but you can tell that he just got sloppy with that football. He broke down on his fundamentals, and he gave it up.
P. Ryan Kerrigan was there for the stop.
The defense filled up all the gaps. The back was looking for somewhere to run, but by bringing the run blitz, they took away all the holes and stopped them for a minimal gain.
Fires a laser down the middle.
Whoa, that was really lucky that one wasn't picked off. Not a good decision at all there.
Throws to his right. Tight coverage, and it's picked off. He's got room. Running strong downfield. Can he get there? And he's gone. Comes down with it. Touchdown.
Wow, he closed on the ball quickly and came up with the interception. Yeah, he took a risk going for the ball there because he didn't have any help behind him, but when you're that good at closing and attacking the ball, you can certainly afford to gamble occasionally.
And it's amazing what talent will let you get away with. Gano gets ready to kick it away. Jones is deep, looking to return the kickoff. We'll see what the offense does to combat their last mistake, which... ended with the defense celebrating a touchdown. Doughty was there to bring him down. Short pass to his left. He's wrestled down at about the 19-yard line by Alexander. Austin gains 4 yards with that reception. Romo gives it up the middle. And the tackle was made by Adam Carricker. On the ground, up the middle. The stop was made by O.J. Atagwe.
And when you can run the ball for first downs, it sets up the play action. Now look for this team to be able to mix it up, and that can be so tough on the defense.
Passes out to the left. O.J. Atagwe was there for the stop.
You know, tight ends may not come up with those real explosive plays down the field all the time, but they sure are a nice target for the quarterback.
Romo gives it left, and he'll lose yardage on the play.
And I really like the discipline of this defense. You never see these guys trying to do too much. They control their gaps, and that time, there was nowhere to go.
We've played a quarter. The score, 7-0. Still looking for an open man. Short throw to the right. The pass falls incomplete. No completion that time, and it'll bring up third down. Surveys the field. Moves up in the pocket. Defense pushes him out of bounds at the 32-yard line. Tony Romo has moved his offense well on this series. It started back around their own 15. And the tackle was made by Brian Arakpo. He hasn't had a good first half at all. Just can't seem to get through this defense. And looks left, throws, it's picked!
And you could really see him baiting the quarterback on that one. He wanted him to believe the receiver was open, but he had it all the way.
Number 29, left side.
The Redskins are simply getting stuffed on nearly every rushing attempt. They need to get a spark somehow because this just does not bode well for them.
Searching for an open man. Watch out, he's got space. He gets knocked out of bounds right around the 44-yard line by Sean Lee. Passes out to his right. Sean Lee was there to bring him down. Pass completed, gain of 9. Garrard hands it off straight ahead. And that was a good effort to get the first. Hands it to the back.
The Redskins actually get a little bit of yardage there. They've been shut down in the running game so far.
Garrard with the give. Gets to about the 37. Antoine Odom was there for the stop. They'll throw for the first. Dumps it out left. The stop was made by Mike Jenkins.
David Garrard sure is looking confident throwing the football right now, and that's good to see because if he struggles, typically it's with his accuracy.
Number 29 will run it again.
The Redskins are not doing a good job at all on the ground so far. They need to somehow get that turned around because if you can't run it, boy, it is tough to throw the football.
Good coverage downfield. Tons of pressure. He's hit as he throws. Fred Davis was the intended receiver.
Yeah, it wasn't close because the big guy was giving him a whack just as he let that one go. He was really under some pressure that time.
Give to the tailback.
5, the ball carrier, 8-12.
Too close to call. Here comes the chain gang. He did not make it. Turnover on down. He splits the uprights. So that will make the score the Redskins. 10, the Cowboys. Nothing. Gano is ready to kick this one off. Jones is back to receive the kick. The Cowboys come back out looking for better results than their last time on the field. Doughty was there to bring him down. Goes through his progression. Picked off! He's dropped down around the 19-yard line by number 64. Number 29 takes the give. They pick up a chunk of about 6 yards.
Gain of 6 on the play.
He throws short. He gunned that one in there for the first down, didn't he?
He really did. And when you watch a guy throw a ball that hard, they don't move their arm any faster. You see them driving off that back leg. That was a pretty pass.
Give to the fullback, and he's in there. Extra point is good. Washington is just about ready to kick this one away. Jones stands back to field the kick.
Yeah, no question. He would have definitely been better off just taking a knee on that one. He was trying to make something happen, but I'm sure his coach is going to have a little something to say to him when he gets to the sideline.
Looking for a man. He's dragged down on the play. The quarterback had no chance on that play. Talk about raw determination by the defender to get into the backfield.
Yeah, not a lot of pretense on that play, huh? He is so strong, it seems like he can bulldoze through these huge offensive linemen almost at will. They're going to need to find a way to double-team him if they ever hope to keep him off their quarterback.
And that opens up room for other defenders.
Yeah, exactly, and that's another reason why he's so dangerous. You need two guys to shut him down, which allows one of the other defenders to get after the quarterback unblocked.
He's searching for a receiver. Passes short right side.
The Redskins did an excellent job tackling and keeping things in front of them on that series to force the three and out.
Number 16 fields the ball at the 34.
That was really a good effort. There wasn't a ton of room for him to run, but he was able to get up the field, get a few yards. You never get upset with a punt return guy like that. It wasn't spectacular, but he got the job done.
Still looking for an open man. Buy some time in the pocket.
That play is good.
He gunned that one in there for the first down, didn't he?
He really did. And when you watch a guy throw a ball that hard, they don't move their arm any faster. You see him driving off that back leg. That was a pretty pass.
Has a man to his right. And he's tackled right around the 16-yard line by Elam. And a couple of yards on that pass.
Boy, that's really a nice tackle on that play. Anytime you get man coverage on the outside against a receiver, you have to be able to make that one-on-one play, and he did it great.
He spikes the ball. The Cowboys just took their first time out. Looking end zone as time runs out. He's got it. Touchdown. The PAT is up and good. And I doubt we'll see a deep kick here. They'll probably just squib it to get to the half. And the tackle was made by number 24. Washington will get the ball to begin the second half. Calls for the fair catch. The Redskins bring their hot offense back out. They've taken it downfield for touchdowns on their last two series. Breaking through up the gut. 7 yards.
Number 29 with the carry on the play. 7 yard gain on the play.
Daylight gets out to around the 38. Terrence Newman was there for the stop.
Nothing makes a defensive coordinator cringe more than seeing that kind of run, because then it sets up the play action, and there's almost no way to stop an offense if you can't stop the run and you have to deal with play action.
Here's the give. He's brought down right around the 38-yard line by Hatcher. They go with the pitch to the right. He's got room. He's looking for a burst of speed. Racing toward the end zone. He's knocked out of bounds at the 10-yard line.
And you can see a defense, when they get gouged for a big run like that, they all start looking around and thinking, whose gap was that? Who gave up that big a hole?
The halfback with the carry. The stop was made by DeMarcus Ware. It's a gain of 4. Let's go, baby. Down right. Down right. No, no, no. Stay up. Up the middle. Sean Lee was there to bring him down. That's a 2-yard gain.
Gain of 2.
Hightower, the ball carry, and the tackle was made by Anthony Spencer.
Great play by the defense. You always hear coaches talking about whoever gets lower, get your pad level lower than the offensive lineman. That time, this defensive line did exactly that.
And the kick is good. So after that kick, the score is now the Redskins 27, the Cowboys nothing.
The Cowboys have had a long day so far, and if they don't make something happen on this series, well, you're going to see these players getting more and more frustrated.
Romo hands off to the left. The stop was made by Perry Riley. He's starting to show some frustration after another short game. This defense has really made it tough going. He passes the line of scrimmage. Perry Riley was there for the stop.
And defensive coordinators hate running quarterbacks. They really do. Because it's one more spot on the field that against some quarterbacks, you don't have to defend.
Surveys the field, looks right, throws. And the tackle was made by Lee Botten. And that play could have easily gone for 6.
And when you start to hit a couple of big pass plays, it really puts the defense in a tough spot. They no longer feel quite as brave coming up and defending those short passes.
Murray gets the call. Hammered in the backfield.
The Cowboys have to be frustrated with their lack of running success in this game. I mean, how many times can you get beat like that and still keep trying to hand the football off?
He's looking towards the left side. Lee Botten was there to bring him down.
And you know the amazing thing about this guy? We all talk about his arm strength, but did you see how fluid that delivery was? He didn't even look like he was trying to throw it hard.
Murray gets the carry. He powers into the end zone for a touchdown. Bailey adds the extra point. So, time winding down in the third with the score. The Cowboys 7, the Redskins 27. signals for the fair catch. The Redskins put up 3 points their last time out. He didn't get back to the line.
And when your defensive line can handle their guys up front and not allow the offensive linemen to get down on the linebackers, it really gives those linebackers a chance to look great.
Flips it out short to his left. Knocked out of bounds at the 19.
Good job all the way around by the defense that time. Not only did they have the deep routes completely covered there, but they also had the check down well within their grasp.
Searching for an open man.
The Cowboys did a good job forcing a three and out. Anytime a defense can come up with three solid plays in a row like that, you know they are right on schedule.
So at the end of three, the score is 27-7. The Redskins have the ball and a big lead as we get set for the final quarter of play. Jones gets it at the 23.
That thing had some huge hang time. By the time that he could field it, the coverage team was already on him. Just nothing you can do as a blocker in that case. The ball was in the air too long.
And drop behind the line.
You know, you can draw up any sort of protection scheme and blocking scheme that you want, but ultimately this game comes down to one big man against another big man, and that time the defense's big men, they won the battle.
Coverage downfield. The stop was made by P. Ryan Kerrigan.
Always thought tight ends were sort of like pacifiers for babies. You know, just about the time that you need a little security blanket, you know where to go.
Passes out to his right. It's almost picked off. Goes through his progression. And the tackle was made by Phillip Buchanan. Austin picks up maybe 7 with that catch. Looks left. Here's a short pass.
And I love to watch this wide receiver work. He is so patient with his routes. He gets down low into his cuts, and he really understands what the defense is trying to do to take him away, and he is working them over.
Dumps it out right. He's loose and running strong. London Fletcher was there for the stop. 8-yard gain on that play. Looking for a man. steps up in the pocket, passes out to the left.
Uh-oh, watch out!
He gets knocked out of bounds at the 29-yard line.
The Cowboys are having some success getting the ball down the field on this drive. This offense is clicking.
He's searching for a receiver. He throws short.
And it just goes to show that arm strength isn't everything. Accuracy and touch is something that is so important for a quarterback.
Let's go. Come on. Hey. Still looking for an open man. A burst of speed, and he's in the open. Gone. Get this man a new contract. Watch out. Touchdown. Extra point is good. Dallas gets ready to kick it away. Buchanan is deep, looking to return the kickoff. Calls for the fair catch. The offense takes the field, and we'll see if they can put something together after their last drive ended with a three and out. In heavy traffic.
It's one of the toughest things about getting blitzed is that everyone has to execute their block perfectly. It's one-on-one blocking, one guy misses a block, and your quarterback's sacked.
Surveys the field. Fires a strike to the right. Looked like he had it, but it's knocked loose. Davis was his intended target. Searching for an open man. Has a man out to his right. He drops the easy pick. So the offense will probably head off the field after failing to convert for a first down on that series.
There's nothing more frustrating for an offense to come in and go three and out. That's just embarrassing.
Jones gets the ball at the 36. Takes this one out to the 46. Barnes was there to bring him down.
He did a good job there finding a seam and getting up the field. You know, a lot of people don't realize that being a punt returner or a kick returner is one of the toughest jobs in the NFL. There's a whole lot of things that could go wrong and only a few that can really go right.
Good coverage downfield. Throws it into coverage, easily intercepted.
And I still don't know why he made that throw. I mean, the coverage was there. There was absolutely no spot to put that ball, and he threw it anyway.
Number 29 gets it on the inside. The stop was made by Brady James. He lost yardage on the play.
And you love to see those linebackers playing downhill like that, not just flowing sideline to sideline, but attacking and trying to get in the backfield.
He's going to his right. Throws. He fumbles it. Dallas falls on it, and they have the turnover. Finds room along the sideline.
What a big mistake there. You're trying to seal the deal, and you give up the football. That is absolutely incredible. All you have to do is close this thing out. It should be easy.
Goes through his progression. He's going to be tackled for a loss. Back to the line, but nothing more. Looking for a man. Short throw to the right. And the tackle was made by London Fletcher. Witten gains about 5 yards on the play. Fires a laser down the middle. Bodden is still down, and it looks like he's in a lot of pain. Short throw to the left. He crosses the goal line. Touchdown! Point after is good. With less than 4 minutes to go in the fourth, the score, the Cowboys, 21, the Redskins, 27. Signals for the fair catch. Takes the handoff. He's going up top.
He knows he just got away with one there. That's a ball he should have never thrown.
Garrard. With the toss, the stop was made by Brady James. 4 yards on the carry. He's searching for a receiver.
You know, it really wasn't a horrible call that time by the defense, but anytime you have to try and stop an offense like this in those medium yardage situations, you really have to come up in the coverage.
Yes, he got there. First down. They'll go with the run once again. Anthony Spencer was there for the stop.
That was because the defense filled up all the gaps. The back was looking for somewhere to run, but by bringing the run blitz, they took away all the holes and stopped them for a minimal gain.
Still looking for an open man. Brady James was there to bring him down. Santana Moss makes his third grab. Give to the tailback.
Did you see how fast that linebacker was on that one? Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
Garrard with the pitch. And he's tackled right around the 46-yard line by Elam. Sean Lee was there for the stop, and that should just about do it.
That was a big-time clutch run right there to try and seal this game up. It looks like all they're going to have to do now is just sit on the ball.
He takes a knee. We'll be right back. That'll do it from Arlington. Stick around for the post-game show and wrap up after this. And let's take a look at the Gatorade Performer of the Game.